your ear about me, bring him in. I mean, I really would, you know, it makes for good fodder. It makes for good radio that you bring up, you know, hey, this guy's saying you're crazy. This guy's saying you're this. This guy. So that's fine. But the thing is, you're bad folks. If you're opposing what I'm doing, you're bad. Because all I'm saying is, you can all be in charge of government. I don't want to be in charge of you. The only folks that I know that I'm definitely in charge of are those who work for the government. How I know this? Well, there's the law. If one wants to abide by the law states that... Let's get it out here. So it's exact. So we're getting the exact.
We gotta move quick, Chris. We're gonna close out. I wanted to get you before we left to address quickly, but I wanted you to address two more things.
I got one question for you too.
Go ahead. Ask your question now. That way.
Oh, all right. My question is what's your opinion on the widespread of the persecution of the Christian churches all over the world? And I heard behind closed doors they talking about coming after the Christians over here in the United States of America. And they brought in about 30,000 guillotines.
Okay. There's a little bit about this, and maybe we'll touch on something called Noahide Law, Noahide, Noahide Law. That's according to congressional records, Congress has advocated and put forward that the Noahide Law is now the law, and in de facto replacing the U.S. Constitution. So whenever you see Muslims, fake Muslims, or the Israeli Secret Intelligence Service, aka ISIS, which is also, U.S. military operation by proxy, of course. That's not something... Muslims, it's not really an Islamic thing to chop off people's heads. It is part of Jewish law, and so that's what's going on there. So one would have to, I would say, looking into Talmudic law and Talmudism and how they feel about Jesus Christ... And maybe those who are true followers and of Jesus Christ, that they would be targeted. I'd also say that they would do it in a two-prong approach, because they wouldn't necessarily just say like, oh, we're going to come out and we're going to go after the Christians. They're going to persecute the ones that are not the establishment, because the church is the establishment in this city. Dwight Jones attests that he runs a Christian church, but we know that he serves Satan. He's a Saturnalian.
I am glad you bring it up.
And so when we talk about persecution of Christians, I mean, there are true Christians that are persecuted.
They don't want to deal with church folks. They don't want to deal with the mainstream. They want to get those who are opposing the system.
Right.
And that's not, that would be people really more like me.
Yeah.
That I would be the one who would be persecuted. Not Dwight Jones, for example. Not the Baptist Church. Not the mainstream churches that you see. Because all of them are just more corporations.
Yeah.
Franchises within the great franchise.
The real,
they're not going to fool with them. The homosexuality is coming out of the church.
Oh, yeah.
All that stuff is out of the church. So they're not going to do that. All the stuff you just told me proves that they're not going to come after that, because that is them. They're going to come after those that are opposed.
I mean, they burn the churches down overseas right now. Churches that have been up for thousands of years already.
Then you got to watch what they
do. But that's different. That's different than the ones that have been up for 50 years here. Because that's a true.
Then you got to make sure it's really happening. Because
I
question a lot of what they're telling us is going on in these places. They want these places to look so bad.
You know
what I'm saying? Like,
I heard also they said lethal injection is cruel and unusual punishment now, so that's why they bring it back to guillotine.
Yeah.
And I heard some states have already passed it already.
Oh yeah.
Well, I mean, there are receipts. There are, you know, when FEMA or Department of Homeland Security has to, you know, they have to buy those from someplace because they don't have factories.
Could they still got about 30,000 of them here right now?
Well, I mean, I would say that they're, you know, I don't really like Article 3, Section 3 of the Constitution. That says what we should do for those who commit treason. Besides that, I oppose the death penalty. And I have no choice on the other stuff because I didn't make the law. You know, and it doesn't apply to me. But if someone commits treason, then the law says that they get the death penalty. But besides that, I oppose it. The government can't put people to death. You know, that's what, if individuals, if they think something really bad is going on, then they have to do what they have to do, but the government as a whole can't come after people and lawfully execute them unless they've committed treason.
We got a rule. Chris, let me say this real quick. Tell everybody listening, I will not be here Thursday, I don't think, but Chris will be here. Glenn, Chris will be here. The show is yours. Preston has already approved it, and you can definitely thank him as well because it was his idea to give you the necessary time so you can go over this militia deal or whatever it is you need to go over. PT probably be here too, but so Thursday is on you.
Yes, sir.
And after that, I'll touch back basis with you because, as I said, I'm getting back to a little bit of some Bible teaching because I've been doing this for, it's been a long run. It started off with one day and we did a whole lot. We did a whole lot.
Oh, so, yes, sir. Absolutely.
And nobody has ever been a guest this long that wasn't part of us. And so that says it all. So
I appreciate that.
I'm, you know, and you'll be back, I'm sure, the Lord's willing. And we'll go from there. But thank you all both. Thursday, 1:00, ladies and gentlemen, you know where to log in to turn your radio dial. I'm getting out of here. Happy birthday, brother. Happy birthday, everybody out there who's celebrating. We got to go. All right, until next time, this is your favorite pastor's favorite pastor. See y'all later.
Peace.